Hey everybody, it's me, Wildman Beats here, and this is going to be episode 15 of Assassin's Creed Liberation. And in last episode, we did quite a bit. We went up to New York, where we met Connor, back from Assassin's Creed 3. And with his help, we found who is doing the bad stuff up there. And it turned out it was George, who we had rescued and sent with the Patriots earlier. So he turned over to the Loyalists, was actually a commander for him, but we killed him pretty darn well. But now we've come back, and there's an unfortunate truth to our mother that we must address at this point, and it's not a good one. So anyway, thank you for coming to watch this video. I hope you enjoy. And otherwise, let's get into it. Hey, so we're back at the docks. Hey, we could go and collect some money and send out some ships. Unless that's where the next mission starts, which maybe it is. Nah, it ain't. All right. Wait, oh, this isn't our warehouse. Where's ours? I thought that one was. Oh, I didn't mean to climb. You don't need to be doing all this. Aveline always trying to be out here all extra and everything. There's our warehouse. Let's check up on my ships and how much money I've got. Should have quite a bit. $185,000. Holy moly. I'm actually gonna sell the Jupiter. And I'm gonna buy not a brig, but an East India man. A little bit of a bigoted name, but then they provide peppers, but we're actually gonna send. Oh, I should have bought it in Bridgetown so I could have sent coffee to Bordeaux. Damn. Okay, here's what we're gonna do. Now I'm just gonna buy three ships in Bordeaux in Bridgetown. Okay, and now I buy coffee on all of them. 200 each. And I just start sending them to Bordeaux. Look how little coffee sells for in Veracruz. And yet it's got higher risk. Oh, I guess Havana provides it too, so. Okay, send this one to. Oh, oops. I have to buy the coffee first. You'll see something. Nope. Okay. It's not coming. Okay, and then send this one to Bordeaux as well. Now I have to deal with this ship. Gonna buy the spices still. And send that to Seville. And then we got three in Boston, where there's furs and ice. Where do furs sell? $700. That's only less than 300 profit. They demand furs in Bordeaux. Huh. But they do demand ice in Port-au-Prince. I think we'll do ice. Oh, should I replace these ships too? I think I should. Get me more East Indiamen. Port-au-Prince. There, I'm starting to get down this process. And I have somehow taken myself all the way down to 47,000. I had, what, 180 to start with? So I just spent 140,000 on my business ventures. Well, gee. It's quite something. Okay, so let's start heading to our mission. I think I do want to stop at the weapon shop. Normal weapons. Weren't there new ones? I mean, there's this, but I don't have enough money. Should I go for, like, a better pistol? There aren't really improvements on pistols, huh? What about a small weapon? Not enough money. You know what I did want to try? Technically, it's worse than what I got. Yeah, see, this is what I'm... thought I was using. And this is like a little worse, but it looks cool. And I think I want to use it. Yeah, look at that. I got notoriety just from pulling it out. That's how afraid they are of my new weapon.
If your purse is heavy enough.
All right, let's go talk to my mother. She better have some explaining to do. Why is this George man a loyalist commander now, huh? Unmask the truth. Let's do it. Hey, she can play the harpsichord too. I can do that.
Aveline, what a pleasant surprise. I trust you had a safe journey?
Safety. Ha! What a quaint concept.
Aveline, are you well?
You may quit your maternal act, company man. I'm well aware company of your man. True identity.
Oh, Aveline, do not be so angry. Do you think that I do not know where you go when you climb through your window to the rooftops at night? How you play the dainty daughter to your doting father? How you pretend to blend with slaves of all people? As if you could conceal your true self from me. My dear, sweet stepdaughter. You are alive today because I needed you. Because I still need you. For what?
Oh.
Sit down.
Oh, shit. She pulled the gun out. I need to get out of here.
Stop right there.
Wait, they fired. Oh, no.
A little late for that, don't you think? My men will kill you. Then what will be left of your precious brotherhood? At ease. Look at us. So sad. How many years have we worked together for the slaves?
You kept them enslaved on your own terms, out of sight for your ill gain.
You ended that, as was my intention. Monsieur de Ferrer had different ideas. He perverted my peaceful colony something ugly. You had to kill him. I owe you gratitude.
I don't believe you.
Aveline, I love you. I raised you as my own. I was unable to bear children, but you brought light to my life.
My whole life you lied to me.
I am sorry. It was necessary. A mother's duty is to protect. But look at me now in the light of truth.
This is cheesy.
You, who know so well the pain of a life lived in secret, shrouding your power in petticoats and lace, pretending obedience to men who deny you the right to your own abilities. Am I really so strange to you? I needed you to quash the terrorist elements in my organization. I need you still. I cannot let the assassins waste your talents. You are too valuable to me.
As a tool to manipulate?
I know you have been frustrated. Agathe.
I disobeyed. De Ferrer would still live if he had his way.
You see, your aims match mine. Join me, Aveline.
Whoa.
Finish what you started.
What? I mean, she doesn't really have a choice. That's the thing. Her mother's acting all like compassion, like, oh, blah, 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 blah. But she had her at gunpoint, too. Following a confrontation with the company man, Madeline, the Isle, her beloved stepmother, Aveline finds herself confused and alone. She journeys to the bayou to seek Agate's counsel and test her own faith in the Brotherhood. Agathe is not going to be happy.
Agathe.
The student returns. Why? What use have you suddenly found for old Agathe?
I have discovered the identity of the company man.
What? Did you not kill him years ago?
That was not the company man.
You ignored my warning, and now you see your error.
It was your responsibility to know as much as mine, Agathe. I was a child when you brought me into the Brotherhood and made me an assassin. You pretended to protect me, to root out the enemy. And all along, my own stepmother, Madeleine, was the company man.
Iniquity runs in the family.
What?
Agathe, stop! Recover your senses! No! It cannot be!
What?
Agathe! What have you done to me?
The order is the future.
No?
Wait! Who are these people?
What?
The lock is
fog.
I know it well.
Why is there no counter button?
But you
what? What in the world? Oh, that's not good. Oh, man, I did the fucking weapon throw again. I guess when you push Y while you're holding your big weapon, you throw it.
Agathe, stop! Recover your senses.
What if I do this?
No, it cannot be. Agathe, what have you done to me?
I used a little tomahawk.
What are you doing? Order is the future.
Oh, come on.
What?
It's not letting me counter. It's not letting me. Dude, this is so dumb. This is like showcasing all the problems with this game.
Go ahead, assassin. The lock is here. I know it will.
But you.
Wait, really? Really? I need to shoot him. This is so dumb. The combat in this game,
does
they just
your conscience
did
attack you?
Really bad idea job
Agathe,
with.
Stop!
That day, when the sailors attacked you, I should not have intervened. I thought you had the spirit of a warrior, like your mother. But you only take after your father. That waxy, pale slave master.
You have no right.
Hey, his claims must not be so different.
I like this weapon though. Oh, dang.
No, it's an illusion.
Well, duh, these have all been illusions.
No, you are mistaken.
Damn, I can't get this dude. What do I need to do? Switch to... Switch to the whip. That is what I needed to do. Okay.
Poisonous deception. Nothing more.
Well, that poisonous deception can kill me. So... Oh. Hey, why didn't I just... Oh.
Just open your eyes.
Oh! Why? Why? This game sucks. The fuck is this trash? Fix your game, Bethesda.
Whoa, now we've got you.
Ay, ay, ay. I killed him with the whip. All right.
Agate, it doesn't have to be like this. The shards of the Chichen Itza disc. Work with me. Tell me what they are for.
Wait, why is this suddenly about the shards?
I told you never to speak to me of that. The knowledge, it will destroy us all.
And without it, we will continue to stumble blindly towards what?
Not towards. Away. Put it from your mind.
Talk to me, Agate.
Mentor, do not force my hand. The Agate who trained me is a man of truth and courage. I know he still lives within you. Let him out again.
Oh. What have I wrought? I should have stayed with your mother.
What?
You should have been my child. Raised as a daughter. Not twisted into this monster.
Go now, Agate. Run. And promise never to return.
What?
You would bid me a coward's slow, pointless death, as you did Uyoa. I will not live with the dishonor. I...
Agate! No!
Oh. Yep. Dang, I did not do well on those conditionals. Yikes. That was a really dumb mission in general, though. Agate's failure as an assassin and his lack of trust in Aveline leaves her completely adrift. She returns to Madeline, ready to embrace her stepmother's cause. She's flipping sides. Oh my goodness. Uh-oh. But at the same time, that mission sucked. Why is combat so bad in this, where it's like, oh, you countered, you can't do anything? It's like, It makes no sense. Oh, your whip. It won't work.
I have done as you asked. He is dead. And the disc.
No, 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 no. Why?
Do you swear to uphold the principles of our order and all that for which we stand?
I do.
To never share our secrets nor divulge the true nature of our work?
I do.
And to do so from now until death, whatever the cost?
I do.
Then I welcome you into our arms, sister. Together we shall usher in the dawn of a new world, one in which our hands will ensure that all things find their proper place.
Why is she wearing weird-ass clothes?
You are one of us now. May the Father of Understanding guide us.
May the Father of Understanding guide us.
What the fuck? Oh, and that's how it ends? Oh no! The Templars win! Wait, that was like the shortest credits I've ever seen. Assassinate Citizen E! Right, okay, there's an alternate ending, and this is what the assassins want us to see. I don't even know if I'm going the right way. Oh. Oh, I see Citizen E, but it's gonna be a long way to get to them. Actually, aren't I almost there? Kind of close. Yeah, I am almost there. Citizen E, I apologize, but you are going down. So I guess we'll see what the assassins say what happened. Oh.
It does not work! Why can't I understand? It cannot be. I refuse to believe it. All these wasted years, a lifetime of sacrifice, and we have all the pieces, I am certain of it.
A piece of Eden.
Unless.
Oh, there goes that conditional. Start running. And why am I on? What happened to my weapon? I never switched over. Get him. Yeah. What? The fuck is going on? I got her. One hit.
Why? You can blame Chichen Itza and De Ferrer, but I see through you. My daughter. No. Daughter? Only two people can call me that. You banished one and sacrificed the other. Foxglove. You killed my father with your care and your tonic. Why? Because he never truly loved
you. Oh, I was right. I thought she poisoned him.
My mother? You stole her child, sent her away. You kept her enslaved even after my father had freed her. And now you attempt to return me to that fate. In the service of humanity. In work. The purpose for which you were created. We were created. The highest purpose. I will not serve you.
No! Dang, did you just stab her in the stomach? At least get her in the neck. Jeez. Oh.
There will be great sacrifice.
The amulet.
Great sorrow to end the enslavement of the human race.
Now is the time to claim our freedom.
The Juno.
I am.
Eve will lead us.
Eve will lead us.
That's it.
It is done.
Okay, now they have the real credits. So the Templars didn't, well, that's just, again, maybe that's just my interpretation of Citizen E, but it's like assassins in present day hacking into the game to show what really happened. But if it's what really happened, it's really just what the assassins, like, they could be injecting it in, and that's how I'm interpreting it. It's like, okay, the game we play is what the Templars want us to believe, and what the assassins put in is what the assassins want to believe. What the truth is could be either one or something in between. But overall for the game, I guess I have to do my little judgment of how good the game was right now, but I think the plot was good. I think some of the mechanics were good, with having, you know, the whip was cool, having different personas. The missions were pretty good. But it felt like just the polish was not there in the slightest. And it did feel a little bit empty in some senses. Like the stores, like the weapon store, the fabric store, they were just a door you'd walk in and get the stuff. There was no, you know, in AC2, how you have a little greeter, like, oh, come buy my wares, and, you know, that kind of thing. I kind of like that. It makes it feel more alive. And they didn't really have that kind of stuff in this game where you felt like there was actual people. It was just whoever's walking around, and that was it. But mechanically, the game was shit. A lot of the mechanics just didn't work. Like, if they did, it would have been cool. Like, the whip would have been cool if it worked. My weapons, my countering was horrible, and that's like the biggest part of combat. Like, you're constantly countering when you're in a combat sequence. So that was just really upsetting. And while the personas were cool, the utilization of them felt pretty non-existent. Like, it forced you into the lady outfit for, like, the ball and stuff like that. And it's like, whatever. It's like, it didn't feel like like there was a mission where it's like, oh, I could do this in the slave outfit and be able to do this and that, and that would be really cool. It's just like, no, assassin outfits just kind of better in 90% of situations, unless a specific quest forces me to do the other one. So it's a bit unfortunate. And just the voice acting for Aveline was decent. The actual animation for her while she was talking was miserable. I mean, she'd do things where, like, you could tell she should be smirking or something. And they made Ezio smirk all the time in Assassin's Creed 2, you know, his little cheeky comments. Our boy gave him character, and they could have done that with Aveline. But she would say something cheeky, and her face would just be, like, no emotion, nothing. She'd say, like with a straight face, like, oh, Gerard, you really want to kiss me or something, you know? And she'd just say, you know, not even looking at him. She'd be looking, like, past him. It's like, so it takes me out of it. It's unimmersive. The economy thing, the ships. Honestly, I would have been fine if they got rid of the ship stuff entirely and just made it so that all costs were lower. It just kind of took me out of the game. But I felt like, oh, I needed money, so I got to do it. And that's why I did it. What else is there? Duration of the game? This took about 15 episodes, so it's about a 10-hour game. Honestly, not very long. So in terms of length for money, now it is supposed to be just kind of a, not a DLC, but kind of a DLC for Assassin's Creed 3. So maybe duration, that's fine. Graphics, this was HD version. I guess it looked HD. What do you guys think? I still enjoyed playing the game, but there were definitely things they could have done a lot better to make me enjoy it more and take out the big frustrating moments. So yeah, I think I'd give it like a 6.5, maybe a 7 out of 10. No, 6 or 6.5 out of 10. I wouldn't even go up to a 7. It just, the lack of care and polish, just kind of, there's no, that's not acceptable. Would I recommend playing it? If you care about the storyline, yes. If you don't, no. I think other Assassin's Creed games are just playing better. So, that's kind of where I sit on it. Music, hey, this soundtrack's good, but some of the soundtracks were a little bit lacking. But overall, I actually wouldn't go back and say, like, oh, the soundtracks were shit. They were fine. I don't think there's gonna be any soundtrack in this that's gonna be super memorable to me. Whereas I definitely had some in like 3 and 2 and 1 that I hear it and it just takes me back to the game. I'm like, oh yeah, that reminds me of this, and you know, Leonardo da Vinci and his invention from AC2 or something. I don't think there's anything like that in this game for me. But it wasn't horrible, you know, it was fitting, it wasn't out of place, it was well balanced, it kind of flowed seamlessly between areas, but overall, nothing memorable. Agate as a character was pretty horribly made, you know? It was just like, it made no sense. It was like, oh, a demon's come over me, and oh, I should have done this, and I should have treated you better. It's like, why? I feel like it would have made more sense if he just, like, stuck to his place, where, like, you should have listened to me, and this is all your fault. And then she kills him. I feel like that would have been an ending to Agate that just made more sense. What it turned into was just like cheesy, and oh my god, I did not care for that ending. at least the ending to Agate. But the ending to the game I thought was all right. The little meeting with Connor up in New York to kill off George was, I'm kind of glad they did it, just because it shows some interconnectivity between the Creed. But I don't know, it just seemed kind of out of place too. But anyway, I think that's all I've got to say about this game here. So if there's an end cutscene, it'll skip to there now. But if not, that'll do it for Assassin's Creed Liberation, and we'll be continuing on with the series hopefully shortly. I don't think it's going to be such a big gap as between AC3 and this one. Hopefully we'll be going on the Black Flag pretty soon. And otherwise, thank you for subscribing, liking, hitting that bell button, and commenting, of course. I love reading the comments. And don't forget to check out the Discord so you can recommend the next game or do that in the comments as well. Either one is fine. And as always, have a great day.